Let's look at how address translations work in an architecture that supports address space tags in the TLB. Recall that the virtual addresses are being generated on behalf of a particular process, and the process has a process ID that is uniquely assigned by the operating system for that process. So when we make an entry into the TLB, what we are storing in the TLB is not only the tag that is associated with a particular virtual address, but also the PID of the process for which we are creating this entry in the TLB. So in other words, every entry in the TLB is flagged with the process ID that that particular entry corresponds to. So how does address translation work in this address space tag TLB? Well, similar to a normal TLB, we're going to take this virtual address and split it into two parts, the index part and the tag part. The index part is what lets us look up a particular entry in the TLB. And from the TLB, we get two tags. One tag is the address space tag. This is signifying which process created this particular entry. So what we want to do is we want to compare the PID of the process that is currently generating this virtual address against the tag that is contained at that entry. And this matching hardware is going to say yes or no. If it says no, then we are done. Then this entry does not correspond to the virtual address that we're trying to translate here. On the other hand, if it does match, this entry does correspond to this process, then we want to ask the question whether the tag that is associated with this entry is the same as the tag that is contained in the virtual address. So that's the second level of matching that goes on. And only if both the process ID matches and the tag matches do we have a hit in the TLB. So in other words, there is two level of matching going on. And therefore, when we do a context switch from one process to another process, there is no need to flush the TLB on the context switch because the TLB may contain some translations on behalf of the previously executing process, and it may contain some translations that correspond to the new process that has been scheduled on it. And the hardware disambiguates these entries by doing this second level of matching of the process ID against the address space tag that is contained in the TLB. But if the memory management hardware does not support address space tag, then what do? And this is a case, for instance, in the Intel architecture that the TLB does not have address space tags.